What's up guys and welcome back to the channel. At the end of The Rise of Skywalker, after Rey eventually reveals herself to be a Palpatine and destroys Palpatine, she ventures to the planet of Tatooine, where the story of Star Wars originally started with Luke Skywalker on his homestead. We then see that Rey then buries the two Skywalker twins' lightsabers together near Luke's original home in A New Hope. But when questioned by a weary traveler what Rey's name is, Rey responds with Rey Skywalker after seeing both the Force ghosts of Leia as well as Luke. And today, thanks to the writer of The Rise of Skywalker, we actually have a full explanation on this choice, and why Rey made this choice, as well as why the filmmakers wanted Rey to be called Rey Skywalker at the end. He also explains the choice to make Rey a Palpatine in Star Wars Episode 9, and what it set up in Star Wars Episode 8. So let's go ahead and read from this interview. You can leave Star Wars Episode 8 and say, well, now Rey is content. She's discovered her parents aren't Skywalkers, or whatever, and that's fine. Although she did get some answers in Star Wars Episode 8, we didn't feel that the story was over for her and her parents. We felt that there were still more questions in Rey's head about where she came from and where she was going. So that was the other big idea that we had to address in this film. Ryan's answer too, what's the worst news that Rey could receive about her parent? That was at the time that she came from junk traders, and that's true, she does come from junk traders. But when JJ and I spoke, he said, well, what's an even worse answer? What's a worse elaboration to that question and the news? And we thought the worst answer that we could give was that she descended from the family who are the enemies of her new family, her adoptive family, that being Leia and Luke specifically. Discovering that you actually descended from your adoptive family's greatest enemy, the same enemy who corrupted Anakin Skywalker and is responsible for the destruction of the Skywalker family in the first place. That felt most like the most devastating answer to us. Based on that, we were very moved by the idea that Leia would have known that from the very beginning, but since she still saw such hope, heart, and spirit in Rey, she decided that she was going to take a chance on putting all of the hope of the galaxy into the hands of a descendant of her greatest enemy. As Luke says, some things are stronger than blood. That felt like a really strong story point to us. The galaxy is full of Force users, and you don't have to be a Skywalker or a Palpatine in order to be strong in the Force. But Luke does say very explicitly in Return of the Jedi, the Force is strong in my family. And we know that there is an inherent element to this Force power. You can't actually get it from your family. So considering that this was a story of the Palpatines and the Skywalkers, at least these 9 movies, we decided to focus on the family part. Rey descending from a Palpatine doesn't negate the idea that kids with brooms, Finn, and other number of people in the galaxy can actually be strong in the Force. It just so happens that this young girl that we found in Episode 7, which really has the structure of a fairy tale, is royalty of the dark side. What we discover in this movie, and hopefully in retrospect, is that she's essentially a princess who's being raised as an orphan. The idea that this royalty of the dark side would be found as a scavenger in the middle of nowhere, literally living in the ruins of the old war that was created by her ancestors. That felt like a really strong idea to us. As far as exactly why Rey took the name of Rey Skywalker, Chris Terrio, the writer, said this. During the end of the movie, when Rey declares herself a Skywalker, that felt like the end of the conversation, which is to say that you get to choose your family, and really, you get to choose your ancestry. Rey rejects the blood ancestry that she has inherited, and instead, she chooses the ancestry of a Jedi. All of the Jedi, in fact. When all of the Jedi come to Rey at the end, one of the Jedi Light says, "We are your ancestors now," in the background, and I think that that's very true. She chooses the spiritual ancestry of the Jedi instead of the blood ancestry of Palpatine. But there it is, guys. That was a full explanation on exactly why Rey took the name of Rey Palpatine at the end of Star Wars Episode 9, The Rise of Skywalker. But what are your thoughts on this, and how did you guys feel about ultimately in the end a Palpatine taking on the name Skywalker? As always, my friends, thank you so much for watching. May the Force be with you, and have a great day.